kalau kita nampak ada talent yang baru, yang talent yang boleh kita bantu be successful, we will look at that lah, right? In terms of PUBG Mobile, I suppose kita takkan ada team lain kan, takkan nak ada Yudu Gang 2 ke Yudu Gang Junior kan. Hi, nama saya Takman, saya ketua Yudu. And Yudu powered by Celcom adalah sebuah digital telco yang membenarkan consumer mengubah suai data, voice dan SMS. Ya, yeah, Yudu dilancarkan pada 2018 dan bila dia dilancarkan, ia adalah untuk consumer yang modern, consumer yang digital. Apakah ya consumer modern kan? So a consumer that's modern is one that is able to be individual, right? Has their own preferences, are passionate about things like gaming, right? Are passionate about things about music and so on, and they would want to customize their own plan. So when we decided to do that, we wanted to be able to allow the customer to choose their own voice, data and SMS, right? So we felt that the customer could do it better. Mereka buat sendiri lagi bagus. Right? So that's why we decided that, okay, the hashtag would be you do it better, and then we shorten it, it became you do. Well, Yudu has been around for 2 years, so we have been busy with a lot of things, right? One of them, of course, is to build the digital brand itself. So we have done a lot of things around that. The other things that we work on is the lifestyle segments, which is basically e-sport, active sports, music and entertainment. So we've been doing quite a lot of things around that, especially along the grassroots level. So recently, pada bulan March, we actually wanted to launch Yudu 2.0, kan? Tetapi kita tahu kan ada pandemic dan kita tak bolehlah buat big event, right? So kita launch everything online. What happened was that we launched with new products. So kita ada banyak new product di dalam Yudu. So things like renew anytime, right? Yeah, maknanya you can tukar your punya plan pada bila-bila masa, right? And then Power Pass, which is about you get 100 gigabytes of data for 1 hour for only RM2. And we have also some reward system. Bila you beli add-on, 10 add-on, you akan dapat satu percuma. Right? So all these are new products. We also were busy with tournaments, right? E-sport tournaments, announcing a new lineup for our e-sport team. And of course, we also were involved in terms of music and entertainment. So we've been pretty busy, actually. Well, I suppose it will affect all of us. Kalau siapa yang kata tak affect, I think that's not so true lah, right? This pandemic memang nobody would have figured out or expected how big the impact is. Tapi sebagai sebuah business, sebuah digital telco, I think we were not affected too much, right? Because at the end of the day, we have already been pretty digital, right? In terms of our processes, in terms of our system. So operation-wise, not so much. Of course, sekarang lebih banyak video call, right? Bila MCO started, kita semua kat rumah. So that affected a little bit of operations, but otherwise, we've been able to work it out lah. Then from a customer standpoint, we already serve digitally. Maknanya kita tak ada retail outlet kan? So kita tak ada retail outlet yang perlu ditutup. So that means everything is done on the app, right? You beli plan baru, you renew plan baru, you bayar, semua dalam app. So kita tak perlu ada distance physical, meet dengan physically kan. So itu tak perlu. So I think at the end of the day, we have not been affected too much. Actually, our business has actually grown. Well, I think the feedback has been good. Kalau tidak, I suppose after 2 years, saya tak akan berbincang atau berbual dengan kamu sekarang kan. So actually, it has been growing quite fast. I think why it's been successful, it's because of, we always say the modern customer lah. So apa tu modern customer? Customer yang dia nak individualistic sikit, right? Bukan negatif, tapi dia nak dia punya persona sendiri, dia nak dia punya plan sendiri, right? And we've been able to provide that, kan? Because our plan, at the end of the day, sekarang kita ada 350,000 plans tau. In a sense, kombinasi, right? Basically, you can choose this amount of data, this amount of voice, this amount of SMS. So at the end of the day, you got so many different combinations which actually meets the individual customer lah, the segment of one. Untuk sekarang, kita tak ada plan yang sama. Because as I mentioned just now, we are actually allow you to choose your own plan, kan? So our system, our app allows you to pilih apa yang kamu mahu lah dengan sendiri, right? you can choose, if you kalau you nak banyak data, you can choose a lot of data. If you need a lot of voice, you can choose a lot of voice. If you just need add-on for, let's say, PUBG Mobile, you can just choose that. If you just need an add-on for Netflix, you can just choose that. So that's why we actually give the power back to the customer, right? So in a sense, the customer has an opportunity to choose what they want. Well, I suppose the main unique part is still the Ubasuai portion, right? The customization portion. Because at the end of the day, you can choose the data you want, the voice you want, the SMS you want. What is different also is that we have this thing called an add-on, right? Which means that kalau you nak beli, you want nak data untuk Netflix, untuk tengok Netflix, we have 20 gigabytes of data that at a certain price, right? If you want to play PUBG Mobile, right? You also have an add-on just for that. So I think that's pretty unique, right? There's something else that we also are pretty unique is our roam like home plans. But I suppose untuk masa sekarang, bila ada pandemic, you don't travel so much, right? But the roam like home plan is very unique is that you can use your plan dekat sini, di Malaysia, you can bring it overseas. So kalau you ada data plan 5GB di sini, you can go to Singapore, you buy a pass that is for 24 hours and you can use all your plan here overseas. So I think that one is a bit different, no other telco also has it. Yeah. Well, I suppose e-sukan or e-sports, it's first thing is very popular in the world. And also in Malaysia. Kita tahu di Malaysia, and I read somewhere, ada 20 juta gamers. Kan? Or, you know, the gamers doesn't mean it's just gaming macam Mobile Legends, bukan PUBG Mobile saja. Ada yang main Pokemon Go, ada yang main Candy Crush kan. But we know there is about 20 million gamers out there in Malaysia. And 75% of them are mobile gamers. So potensi dan quantity customer di sini, banyak, sangat besar. So naturally, as a brand, as a digital telco, we want to engage this big cohort or big bunch of customers, right? And the only way is to give them what they want, right? So as a telco, kita bagi connection kan? You are guna data untuk main game. So that's one. My second thing is to be able to give content, to be able to engage with the customers. So that's why we get involved in esports. Another reason is also that I think esports in Malaysia has an opportunity to be something good for Malaysia, right? It will grow big, like as recently we have people, our teams that are involved in tournaments who are representing Malaysia, right? Doing very well. So I think there's an opportunity to support the industry in Malaysia. So that's why we want to get involved in this. Well, I suppose first thing is there was an opportunity, right? And also this opportunity came up, right? So when we started the first tournament, right? When we got involved in sponsoring the first tournament, PUBG Mobile National Championship dengan Tencent Games, right? The winner of the tournament was Gang, kan? So bila saya kat pentas nak bagi hadiah kepada Gang, kan? So I shake hands with Captain mereka, kan? Man Parang, right? I beritahu mereka lah, kita kena berbincang lah, ada opportunity untuk work together kan. So 2-3 minggu selepas tu, team captain mereka dan team manager mereka, Kevin, they came over to the office. After a few rounds of discussion, we decided that yeah, I think we have similar interest nak grow potensi mereka. So that's how we started working together lah, right? The opportunity to have a team which allows us to engage with our grassroots was there. So we decided to take it, right? And I'm actually very happy that and very proud, right? I think the whole Yudu, the Yudu fans and Yudu gang fans are very proud that the team has done so well. And as you all know, they recently won the Southeast Asia Championship. So they have grown a lot, right? And that's why we've been so happy with them. Untuk masa sekarang, kita dah ada team yang lain, kan? We ada di bidang Tekken dan Street Fighter. So Yudu FV, kan? Dikenali sebagai Yudu FV. So that's the second team that we have, right? It's another game itself. We will always look for opportunity. Kalau ada opportunity untuk game lain pun kita akan lihat lah, right? The main thing is to build the grassroots. Kalau kita nampak ada talent yang baru, yang talent yang boleh kita bantu be successful, we will look at that lah, right? In terms of PUBG Mobile, I suppose kita takkan ada team lain, kan? Takkan nak ada Yudu Gang 2 ke Yudu Gang Junior, kan? But it's more supporting the Yudu Gang team. But kalau ada opportunity di game-game yang lain, kita akan... it depends. It will depend on the opportunity. Yeah. 5G is, of course, something which will benefit the public, right? In the sense that speeds are faster, right? The lag is slower, and the ability for more connections, right? Just not just human connection. Sekarang kita punya phone is all about people calling each other. But later is also bukan saja people calling, but machine juga akan call lah, in the sense kan. There's connection interface between machines, machine to machine, machine to human, human to machine, human to human kan. So definitely you need that 5G aspect to be able to cope with the bandwidth that's required. So in terms of how we are going to be getting involved, it really depends, because it's still very exploratory at the moment, and investment yang banyak diperlukan. Definitely there is a plan to do that, right? But of course this is we will be also be guided by our parent group lah, Celcom and so on. Kita baru launch a lot of new plans in March, right? So in terms of new plan untuk masa sekarang mungkin tak ada for the next few months, right? But of course being a company that's very innovative, kan, we will continue to think of new plans, right? So we will always have new plans, new promos. The other thing that we always work on to build our customer base is the lifestyle segment, kan? Kita selalu menceburi dalam isukan, music dan hiburan, dan active sport, right? Active sport untuk masa sekarang kita get involved in futsal, but of course masa pandemic sekarang kita tak boleh, futsal tak berlaku lah, right? So naturally we will continue to be involved in things like e-sports, right? We will be involved in the music scene, and actually you will also see that we will start to get involved in K-pop. That's I think something which we think that we will be able to help engage the K-pop community and support them in the future. Well, I suppose to our Udo customers and Udoers, right? Thank you for supporting us all this while, right? We have been going through ups and downs, right? I think a lot of ups, right? And we are very supportive of you, and we thank you also for very supportive of us. Continue to look out for us for new plans, new innovative plans, right? Excitement in terms of esports, in terms of music and entertainment, and also active sports.